So excited I found this. I promised you if I found the video of myself and Malky who sacrificed whatever it was, a goat, a sheep, on the Mount of Olives, I would share with you. I have found the footage, and I will allow you to decide for yourself. Watch this, decide for yourself. Now, quick backdrop, as you know, I mentioned it before, Malky recognized me from YouTube. We met in the Tomb of David, and the Tomb of David is the center for the seven Noahide laws. In the beginning of this conversation, we're talking about something called chakras. Those chakras we know to be Eastern religion. Okay? I forget what it is, Buddhism, Hinduism, but they're Eastern religion, different gods. So that's how this begins. I'm just gonna allow you to watch this, decide for yourself, and I'm just really, really excited that this footage is something I can share with you.
What is evil?
Why is chakra evil?
Because it is Eastern religion.
Yeah,
it is paganism. It is coming from fallen principalities.
Okay. What if I just told you? What if
it's Babel. Babel is confusion. It's trying to get into God in the back door. Jesus Christ is the door to the sheepfold. Okay? And anyone comes in as a thief or a robber. That's what these things are. Buddha, all of them, they're thieves and robbers. They're trying to get people to somewhere that only Christ can get them. Okay?
Right.
And we renounce these things. Okay? This is Mr. Babylon. This is witchcraft.
What if
this is sorcery.
It's
okay?
Because you're associating
now,
that with them.
Now, the reason this is happening is because we got this conference coming up. Okay? We got this conference. You can see on the conference the chakra. These people are sacrificing animals to those gods, and so are you.
That's
what's going down right here, okay? So we got down seven Noahide laws, seven chakras, seven divine emanations, getting these stupid nations, even ambassadors, to sacrifice an animal to who? Hashem.
What do you think the seven?
Hashem ain't God. He ain't Yahweh.
What do you think the seven sacred emanations are?
I don't care.
What are the seven? What are coming off the throne of God?
It's the beast.
What's coming off the throne of God? It's seven spirits, seven emanations.
That's different.
It's different than what?
Then chakra. Chakra is not the same.
You're associating something. I'm just trying to tell you.
I am associating something.
Let's
separate.
Let's forget about chakra and let's just call it God's gate.
No, we won't.
Why?
You called it chakra. That's what it is.
Because I know what it is. That's a lot of
and you're combining chakra with the menorah.
Because
it's
exactly
mixture.
What it is. It's his light. See, we're his menorahs on this earth. And we're meant to
we are his menorahs. That is correct.
We're
chakra is not his menorahs.
What are coming out of a menorah?
Light.
Light. Okay.
Jesus
so
Christ
what is
the light.
What are we, if we are menorahs, and if we're a temple, what is supposed to be emanating from us?
Who cares?
It's light.
Who cares what's emanating from us?
It's light. Is it not
this
light?
This is not about us. This is about Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the light.
Of course. So the light.
Jesus Christ is the door.
Did you hear
no
that?
Man can come to the Father but by me. Chakra is
you're
all those other gates
about,
of the feet.
I'm triggering you with the chakras, okay? Please don't be careful what you're saying because you might end up cursing yourself by saying something about God's light that is not appropriate.
Okay, now did you hear what he just said? He said, be careful what you're saying because you might be cursing yourself. Now, what he's doing indirectly is he's trying to intimidate me and actually curse me.
I'm not afraid of nothing, man.
Okay.
This is the war. This is what's going down.
This is
why you were sent to come and bring this chakra.
This is
come on, Leland. Let's go together to this thing.
Right now, you're dealing with it from a spiritual, from a religious aspect.
I'm religious. I'm religious.
Listen to me for a second, okay? What happened to the story where I told you he came into me exposed on my sin?
I don't know what came into you, man.
The Kundalini
you're
spirit is what came into him.
Mine. I don't know what it is.
I
don't know what it is.
False
man.
Holy Spirit.
I'm trying to share with you the light that he's given me.
I don't know what that is.
Well, you won't listen long enough.
I'm saying, look at the
book.
We were in spirit in it. True.
Uh-huh.
I got all kinds of spiritual things I could talk about. I talk about the book. I talk about my testimony to Jesus Christ.
Of course,
he's the light. He's the door.
He is what came in. Guess what you gave this?
But you That's the best thing for us.
Yes, yeah, but it's to just realize that God had a plan for all of it. Everything at the end.
I understand.
He declared the end from the beginning. At the end, he says it was all perfect. And he made every single religion happen. He made everything happen. Or
every religion.
He made the whole thing.
Okay, do you hear that? So God made every religion, okay, happen. Now, basically what he's saying is all those religions are good. So you can see this guy is taking all these different religions and sacrificing his sheep to it. He's been doing this, right? He's talking about all this stuff. And remember, the next day he's going to sacrifice that on the Mount of Olives.
Nothing.
So Islam is good, Eastern religion.
I didn't say it was good. I said he made it happen.
It happened. It's Satan.
Didn't he tell, didn't the angel of God come and tell Ishmael's mother that they were going to become a great nation? And
there was a serpent in the garden.
Of course, but was it the serpent? Who put the serpent in the garden?
The serpent was there.
Right.
The serpent was there.
It was there.
And that's what all this religion, that's what this chakra is. Okay? You can call me religious. You can call me whatever you want.
What I'm trying to say is, so
I'm not worried about
that center, that when his fire came into me, it was then inviting my divorce.
I'm not worried about your religious experience, man.
I'm
worried about
you.
The book. I'm worried about the book.
What are you worried about?
Because you want to go to court, you take a book. Okay. The books are open, not religious experience. Okay?
But if you're so worried about the books, how come you're eating seafood that's not kosher?
Yeah, why are you, seriously, why are you not?
Because he told Peter, here's the sheet of food, eat.
That's why. That's not what he meant, was it?
He's talking about people.
He was supposed to talk with the Greeks.
Yes, it's people.
Peter even woke up and said, I don't know what this dream means, so.
Right.
So it obviously, if it was just about food, I mean, he knew Yah well enough to.
Why would he tell us to curse ourselves?
You know what I mean?
When he gave us the law in order to bless us, why would he then later on tell us to curse ourselves? That's why I told that rabbi in his face. I go, what evil spirit guides somebody to the Torah? He's been guiding me to the Torah because he loves
Yeah, lots of evil spirits lead to Torah, man. Look, read the book of Galatians. Read the book of Galatians. Who has bewitched you? What's that? Witchcraft.
So,
you foolish Galatians.
So, do you believe that the Passover lamb is, that was evil?
No.
But you just basically said that what I did was not.
Show me the Passover, Ezekiel Sample. You can't. You eat the unleavened bread, y'all. Don't kill the sheep. There's a daily sacrifice, yes, you kill a sheep, Ezekiel's temple. It's going to last for 1,000 years. When it comes to Passover, you don't sacrifice a lamb.
What How come do, it says, it even says
you eat unleavened bread. The memorial of Pesach is unleavened bread, not killing a sheep.
So you don't eat lamb on Pesach?
No.
What do you eat?
Unleavened bread.
Just unleavened bread.
That's what it says.
But it says it's a commandment to last for all your generations.
That's right. To eat what? Unleavened bread.
No, it was this is when he gave the commandment of keeping the Passover. He said, do this as a memorial forever.
Which you do.
And then
you do it forever, but you don't sacrifice the lamb forever.
One of the apostles said to keep the Passover.
With unleavened bread.
No, he said with Yeshua being the lamb.
He's, exactly. The lamb has already been slain. You don't do it again.
Amen.
So we eat, we can eat lamb any other day but that day.
No, when we keep Pesach, so we eat unleavened bread. That's what it says, Ezekiel chapter 45, verse 18, when you keep the Passover with unleavened bread.
Right.
And sorry, man, that's what the book says. You can come up with all kinds of stuff to kill a sacrifice. That is not what the book says. It doesn't say that in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. It doesn't say that in Ezekiel's temple. This is what you take to court. Facts.
Okay.
Not religious experience. Okay? So no, we will not be going to this conference together. If you go, that's fine. But you can take you and your chakras over there.
Well,
okay.
I'll take me and the oil over there.
I don't condemn you. I love you, brother. But I'm just saying this stuff is not right.
I know, but I can't tell you how many people I get with just that one word. And
that's because it's wrong. Everybody knows in their spirit
it's wrong. To it.
It's wrong.
But does it not mean that we could actually have these gates in our bodies? Can it not mean that
Who
it's
cares?
Our spiritual bodies? Did he say
what
we
am I concerned with gates?
I care because it's what gets me going every day. It's because he's lit me up with my open my gates so I can actually go to the gym and work out when I wasn't supposed to do any of those things. And the doctors say I can't do it and I shouldn't be able to. And I do all these things by his spirit because he's opened my gates. Because I follow his laws.
Yikes.
And those are just what it is. And I'm just trying to tell you, Satan doesn't create anything. He just perverts God's stuff. So what you're thinking is something pagan and evil and satanic. I'm not telling you. And look at that. I'm trying to tell you God's way.
Yeah.
God does, and this is his tree. Because when he lit me up, it lit up from the center cable, and that center is where he enters, is the heart.
Kundalini spirit.
God bless you. It's all good. We all have our portion to bring, but I told you who I was.
Yes.
And I told you what I did.